My favorite social media scheduling tool, Publat, now has the ability to share Facebook carousel posts. Hey guys, Jonah here from Social Smarty. Today I'm going to show you how to create a Facebook carousel post using Publat. Now the first thing we need to do is create our images. So there is a limitation, we can only share up to 5 images in our carousel. So what I've done is I've headed over to Canva, free account, canva.com. I've got the link in my description there. So once you've got your free account set up, I have created 5 individual Instagram posts. So the Instagram post size, which is 1080 pixels wide by 1080 pixels high. And then once I'm ready to move these images into Canva, I'm just going to click on the 3 dots on the right here, and I'm going to share, and I'm going to look for the Publat icon. Now, because I have already linked up my Publat account, I can see my account is sitting there, and I'm going to share all of those images as PNG files through to my Publat account. And so once we've done that, we're going to head over to Publat. Great, so here we are in Publat. Now we need to create our post. Now, if you are yet to set up your Publat account, go and check out my video on how to do that. I will link to that in the description as well. But the first thing we need to do is select our account. So we're going to obviously choose a Facebook account. I've chosen my page here. Then we're going to come over, and we're not actually going to upload those images. What we're going to do instead is pop in our link. So when we create our carousel post, we're going to have 5 images which people can swipe across. Each one is going to have a link. And so what we need to do is decide where we're going to be sending people. So for example here, I'm just going to take this link to a blog post from my website. I'm going to copy that, and then I'm going to paste that into this box here. So as if I was sharing that link, and what that's going to do is it's going to populate a preview. So you'll see in a minute, a preview of that link is going to pop up, and that's going to form the first slide of our carousel. So what is happening here is Publat is searching for the images that it's pulling through from that blog post. Now, I don't want to use those images. So instead, what I'm going to do is click on the small camera icon, and then I'm going to go into my library because I've pushed those images through to my Canva library. I can click on Canva here, and I'll find that first image I want to use. Great, so I've got that first image here. I'm going to click on Use Media. Awesome, so we can see that that image has replaced that preview image. Now the other things we can do here is we can change the wording here, so we might change that to, and we can also change this description down here if we want to. Great, so once we have changed the title and the description, we can add a button. So down here I might choose Learn More, and then if someone clicks on that carousel slide, it's going to take them to that link that we've popped in there. And now what we need to do is we need to attach another link. So we can either choose to reattach the same link again, or we can attach another link. So say for example you were doing a carousel that was talking about 5 different blog posts, you might have a different link for every single slide. But for this example, I'm going to be sending people directly to one blog post. So all 5 slides relate to one blog post. So I'm just going to click on reattach the same link. And then I'm going to go through the process again. So we've got that first slide that we worked on before. I'm going to go to the camera icon. I'm going to go into my library. I'm going to choose the next image there, use media. Cool, and then I will edit my title. Cool, so slide number 2 is done. Now I'm going to do the same thing with slide number 3. I'm going to switch out that image, change the description and the headline. Next slide, slide number 4, I'll do the same thing. And the last slide, slide number 5. Great, so I've got all five of my slides there all ready to go. They're all using the same link. Remember, you can use different links if you like. The last step is to come up the top here, remove that initial link, and then write my caption. Now, remember that the words that you use in this caption are searchable, so make sure you've got a nice description of what your post is about in there. Great, so I've written my caption. Now I'm going to preview it, and you'll get to see what it's going to look like. So we can see we've got our caption at the top, we've got our five swipeable carousel slides, we've got our descriptions, our headings at the top there, and then our descriptions. And when we're happy with that, we can check the mobile view. Looks great, we'll click close. And then I'm going to go ahead and schedule that. So it's really simple. Try out a carousel post on Facebook. Let me know how you go in the comments.